Hey there, jazz lovers. Are you ready to groove to some hard bop beats? Buckle up, because we're doing a deep dive into Lee Morgan's iconic album, The Gigolo. This isn't just music. It's a roller coaster of emotions, intricate solos, and jaw-dropping performances that'll leave you wanting more. So grab some popcorn, sit back, relax, and enjoy our video. But before you do this, please hit the like button, ring that notification bell, and subscribe to my channel. Thanks. All right, let's set the stage. Picture this, the year is 1965. Jazz is in the air, and musicians are pushing the boundaries like never before. Enter Lee Morgan, a trumpet virtuoso, who steps into the famous Van Gelder studio in New Jersey. The result? The Gigolo, an album that has stood the test of time and continues to captivate us over half a century later. Well, who was Lee Morgan? He was a child prodigy, who was born in Philly in 1938. He picked up the trumpet at a very young age and boom, he was off to the races. He joined Art Blakey's Jazz Messengers and even gave us hits like The Sidewinder. But life had other plans. In 1972, at just 33, Morgan was tragically shot dead. A life cut short, but oh, the legacy he left behind was full of ups and downs. Now let's fast forward to 2013. Music Matters Jazz decides this masterpiece needs a comeback. So, they get Kevin Gray to master it at his now famous studio Coherent Audio from the original analog tapes. And yes, it was pressed at Recording Technology Incorporated, or better known as RTI, on two 180-gram vinyl LPs at 45 RPM. The sound quality of this album is nothing short of phenomenal, offering a richness and clarity that brings each instrument to life. From the punchy sound of Bob Cranshaw's bass, where you can hear his fingers moving across the strings, to the full-bodied sound of Morgan's trumpet, and the crisp clarity of the drums and cymbals, every note is a treat for the ears. Add to that the whisper quiet vinyl, and you have an acoustic experience that's as close to a live performance as it gets. Now let's talk about the music. Hold onto your seats, because Speedball is a musical roller coaster. Imagine a tune that grabs you from the first note and doesn't let go. It's like the musical equivalent of a double shot of espresso. Fast, intense, and absolutely exhilarating. The solos from Morgan and Wayne Shorter are like fireworks, bursting with creativity and technical prowess. And let's not forget the rhythm section. They're the engine that keeps this high-speed train running smoothly. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comments below. Now, let's switch gears and talk about You Go To My Head. This tune is like a warm, cozy blanket on a chilly winter's night. It's the kind of song that makes you want to sit by the fireplace with a cup of hot chocolate. Morgan's trumpet takes on a lyrical, almost vocal quality, telling a story without words. The rest of the band provides a lush, harmonic backdrop that makes this standard tune feel fresh and new. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comments below. Don't think we're done yet, because there's more musical gold to uncover. The tune Yes I Can, No You Can't serves as a dynamic opener, setting the stage for what's to come. On the flip side, the tune Trapped takes the tempo down a notch, immersing you in its bluesy undertones. Then there's The Gigolo, the title track, which stands as the crown jewel of this remarkable album. Now, let's meet the band, starting with the man of the hour, Lee Morgan. He's the trumpet virtuoso who not only led this ensemble, but also shaped the sound and feel of the entire album. Known for his earlier hits like The Sidewinder, Morgan was a force to be reckoned with in the jazz world, and his leadership and artistry are evident in every track of The Gigolo. Next up is Wayne Shorter, the saxophonist who brought his own brand of magic to The Gigolo. A major figure in modern jazz, Shorter has played with legends like Art Blakey and later co-founded the fusion band Weather Report. His contributions to this album are invaluable, offering intricate solos and a unique voice that complements Morgan's trumpet perfectly. Let's not forget Harold Mabern, the man behind the piano keys on this album. Known for his work in the hard bop and post-bop genres, Mabern had previously collaborated with jazz greats like Wes Montgomery. On The Gigolo, his piano work serves as the harmonic backbone of the ensemble, providing both rhythmic drive and melodic richness that elevate the entire musical experience. Now, onto Bob Cranshaw, the bassist who laid down the groove on The Gigolo. Cranshaw was a longtime collaborator with saxophone legend Sonny Rollins and was known for his versatility, playing both upright and electric bass. On this album, his bass lines are not just a foundation but a vital part of the musical conversation, adding depth and complexity to the overall sound. Last but certainly not least, we have Billy Higgins on drums. A prolific session musician, Higgins was known for his work with Ornette Coleman and was one of the most recorded drummers in the history of jazz. On The Gigolo, his drumming is the heartbeat of the album, providing both rhythmic stability and a dynamic flair that adds excitement and nuance to each track. Fast forward to today, and The Gigolo is still a big deal. The reissue has made it a must-have for collectors and audiophiles. It's like the Mona Lisa of jazz album. The fact that Music Matter Jazz is now out of business makes you wish the folks at Blue Note Records would add it to their Tone Poet or Classic Vinyl Series reissues. So there you have it, jazz lovers. The Gigolo isn't merely an album. It's an everlasting voyage into the soulful universe of hard bop jazz. This record is brimming with passion, rhythm, and undeniable spirit. If this video resonated with you, please go ahead and smash that like button, ring the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel for more incredible jazz content. Believe me, your playlist will be forever grateful. Thanks for tuning in, jazz lovers. Keep listening, keep exploring, and most importantly, keep the spirit of jazz alive. Until next time, stay groovy. Bye for now.